I believe that I&EC research is probably more relevant today than ever.
I think it's the place where we all chemical engineers go when we want to see what is going on. And by we, I mean, again, people from industry and people from academia.
Yeah, I think it really fits well with chemical engineering because the discipline is so broad and covers so many different topic areas that a journal that, like IECR, being broad, allows you to have one place to go and look for the information.
Well, I think it allows people to be creative. The range of it is always quite amazing to me. Just looking at the titles, you get a sense of what a lot of people are doing, which you would not get from a specialized journal.
Oh, just in China, everybody in chemical engineering, they think that this journal is the mainstream core journal in chemical engineering.
I find that the I&EC research editors are extremely efficient, and they also pick outstanding referees. So I'm confident when I submit there that I'm going to get thorough and helpful reports back from the referees.
And just in general, ACS journals are incredibly well run and easy to submit to, fast publication times, excellent reviews, and really just a high quality experience all the way around.
So for me, my first paper, and it was a second author paper, but the first time I ever had my name published on a peer-reviewed manuscript was an IECR. And I thought it was so cool. I was so happy that, like, yeah, I'm published. And it was on ionic liquids and CO2. I mean, I felt like they were very supportive of me even as a grad student, and I got to know them. And so IECR really made an impact on me, and I continue to publish there.
Publishing in industrial and engineering chemistry research has given me the opportunity to collaborate with different research groups, and it is a great exposure of your work.
Well, I&EC research is unique in a way that it's at the interface of, and it publishes work from all, both the academic and the industrial sector. And that makes it unique because now you have a broad of research contributions within the journal. It's focused on applied research, but also has an emphasis on fundamentals, processes, and materials, which I think is key at keeping it relevant over time.
The academics publishing in IECR are interested in seeing some of the industrially relevant research that's been published and vice versa. From my own personal experience from the 13 years I spent at DuPont, of all the journals that were in circulation within our central research and development group, I&ECR was by far the most popular.
Yeah, so just commenting as a researcher, you know, the journal I&EC Research has been really important to me. You know, I think back to my days as a grad student, and the first three papers that I published out of my thesis went to I&EC Research, so it helped me sort of launch my own research career and professional identity, and I'm grateful for that. Oftentimes, though, as an author, one of the things I value most is the reviewing process that I&EC Research seems to have down to just fine-tuned details. But there's obviously care, attention that goes into the manuscripts. We invariably get comments back that help us present the work in a better light than we would have, and help, therefore, you know, make more impact as researchers. So I really value the reviewing process and the way I&EC Research handles that. Yeah, so I would like to thank everyone. That includes authors, includes reviewers, includes our editorial team for keeping I&EC Research at the forefront of chemical engineering research since 1909. Please visit and also take time to read our special 110th anniversary virtual special issue. It's available at axial.acs.org.